The whole damn show has arrived.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Battle Creek, Michigan, weighing in at 235 pounds. Rob Van Dam.
RVD is truly one of a kind.
Yeah.
An innovator in the skies, and with weapons, too.
Rob Van Dam is a walking weapon, quite literally, Byron. From ladder matches to hardcore brawls, RVD can get it done in any situation possible.
I'm hoping we'll see a five-star frog splash and a five-star match, courtesy of Rob Van Dam.
True delight on any night.
An entrance like no other.
Hey, who else can slow down time?
Don't worry, Saxton, you'll still be old.
And his opponent from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 215 pounds, John Morrison.
Well, he has attained success in and out of WWE. And he's come a long, long way from tough enough nearly two decades ago.
Broke through barriers and the stratosphere. Morrison makes the impossible look effortless.
Beautiful to watch, but extremely painful to experience.
The guru of greatness is ready for action.
Here's John Morrison, of course, known as one half of one of the great tag teams in WWE alongside The Miz, but one heck of a single star in his own right.
Oh, absolutely, Michael. Morrison spent 8 years outside of WWE sharpening his skill, maturing as an in-ring competitor, growing his confidence, too, if you can believe it.
Yes, a lot of people would say that Morrison's ego only got larger during his time away. But as Morrison has proven with his larger-than-life personality,
flying through the air and connects.
Just crashing down with high impact.
Oh, Morrison manages to counter. Roundhouse kick.
DDT.
Two.
Kick right to the ribs. And there's more to come. Brain Buster.
Corey, what strategy do you recommend when taking on someone with dynamic offense like Rob Van Dam?
It won't be easy, but work on RVD's stamina. If you tire him out, it'll be harder for RVD to execute his most dangerous moves. So time is cool and set up RVD's energy reserves.
Van Dam saves himself.
Good strategy, working RVD's core, tiring him out and draining his stamina.
Series of reversals.
Escape just in time.
He's testing fate here in danger of a count out.
Eight.
Launch out to the outside.
Just a devil-may-care attitude on full display.
Going for broke, and it pays off.
Spin kick to the midsection. Snap there. Kick right in the spine.
Whoa!
He is just reeling from that offense.
This is where endurance becomes so important in the late stages of the match.
Suplex.
serious damage. Bad predicament right here. The referee continues the count, may call it soon.
He's heading back to the ring.
He heads outside. Countout's legal in this match. One. Into a neck breaker.
Two.
Oh, colliding with a barricade.
Three. Four.
Re-entering the ring now.
This could be it. Cover for the win.
And he kicks out of the pin and one.
Giving a massive effort to overcome the pin attempt.
Reversal on Morrison.
Another reversal.
Shot to the corner of the ring.
Kick to the ear by Johnny Drip Drip, and we are all about to take a trip.
Bad spot for RVD.
After that last hit,
goes to show you just never know what your opponent's capable of.
That was a golden opportunity to end things. Now he's got to hope the opportunity presents itself again.
So fluid, so quick. Morrison with that patented offense there.
Oh, guys, watch this. He misses the target. Short flight, but a rough landing.
And down with the suplex.
Disbelief that did not finish the job.
Everyone watching this is in total disbelief right now.
I thought it was over. The WWE Universe thought it was over. But you gotta do a little more to finally finish this. Win in this match.
A win like that proved he is not messing around.
That match was all business from him, Corey, and that worked.